Good morning, students. How are you all? Today we are going to study about the topic getting to know about plants. Now, plants. Okay, we know about plants. We are having plants in our home, right? Now we are going to study about plants and their parts. Okay, you all know the parts also, right? Okay. Next, a nature walk. Okay, if you go outside and observe all the plants around you, what will you see? Some plants may be small, some may be big, and some have green on the soil, like a grass, right? You can observe this type of plants in our surrounding, right? Some plants have green leaves, some have reddish ones, right? Some have red flowers, some have tiny ones, some have no flowers, right? There are variety of plants and variety of structure of plants we are observing in our day-to-day life. Okay, then the next thing is parts of plant. We know the parts of plant. What are the parts? First, from the bottom, right? First one is root, then stem. Root means it absorbs water and minerals. Its main thing is it is absorbing the water and minerals. Okay, what we call the system as root system. Okay, there are two types of systems. What are they? Root system and one is shoot system. Okay, the root we call it as root system. Okay, then shoot system. The shoot system, first one is flower. What is meant by flower? Flower helps in reproduction. Okay, flower helps in reproduction. Okay, first one is flower. Flower head helps in reproduction. Then leaf. What is the form of leaf? What is the use of leaf? It performs photosynthesis. Okay, from sunlight it performs photosynthesis. Then fruit protect the seed. Okay, what is the use of fruit? Fruit it is used to protect the seed. Then stem support the plant. Stem, what is the use of stem? It support the plant. Okay, these are the types of parts. Sorry, these are the parts of plants. Okay, there are two systems. What are they? Shoot system, then root system. Shoot system contain flower, leaf, fruit, stem. But root system contain only root. Okay, then classification of plants. There are three categories. What are they? Herbs, herb, then shrub, then trees. Okay, herbs, shrubs, then trees. Okay, first we study about herb. There are small plants with a green soft stem. Okay, herb means there are small plants with a green soft stem. Okay, with a green soft stem, what we call that plant as a herb. They do not grow more than 3 to 4 feet height. Okay, and may not have branches. Herb have no branches. Okay, it grow more than 3 to 4 feet. Then what are the examples of herbs? Mustard, sunflower, wheat, paddy, etc. Okay, these are the examples of herbs. Okay, then shrubs. Okay, then the second category is shrubs. They are medium sized plant with hard of woody stem. Okay, it has hardy woody stem. Okay, hard woody stem. It has many branches rising just above the ground. Okay, it has many branches rising above the ground. For example, China rose, lemon, etc. Okay, these are the example of shrubs. Okay, ma, first one is herb, then second one is shrubs, then third one is trees. We all know trees, right? Tree all tall plant. We know that. With hard and woody stem. That also we know, right? They have a main trunk from which branches and leaves arise in the upper part, much above the ground. Okay, leaves arise in the upper part, much above the ground. Okay, then trees generally survive more many years. Okay, trees life is more than more many years. Okay, many years, its life is up to many years. Okay, it have more years to live. Example, mango, neem. We know about neem, right? It has many branches. It has a woody stem. We know that, right, ma? Then next type is about leaf. We know about leaf, right? The parts of leaf. First one is petiole. Petiole means, see here, petiole. The lower part of the leaf, it is what we call it as petiole. Okay, the part of the leaf by which it is attached to the stem is called what? Petiole. Okay, the leaf and the stem attached area is called what? Petiole. Okay, then lamina. Lamina means the surface of the leaf. Okay, the broad green part of the leaf, what we call it as lamina. Okay, ma'am, the broad green part of the leaf is called lamina. Then veins. We know about veins. We are having veins. Likewise, leaf also having veins. So that vein shape is called what? Vein. The lines on the leaf is called what? Vein. Then the next thing is midrib. Midrib means the name itself, mid. Mid means middle. The middle, the form of line is called, one line is there, right? That line we call it as midrib. Okay, a thick vein in the middle of the leaf is called what? Midrib. Okay, the vein like lines are called what? The lines in the leaf is called what? Vein. Okay, the thick line present in the center of the leaf is called what? Midrib. Okay, then leaf venation. Okay, the design made by the vein in the leaf is called what? Leaf venation. Then parallel venation. Veins are parallel to one another, called what? Parallel venation. Here also one vein, here also one vein, right? It the two veins are parallel to each other, right? What we call that is parallel venation. Okay, then leaf function. What is the function of leaf? Manufacture food through photosynthesis. Okay, leaf prepare their food in the presence of what? Sunlight. And a green color substance present in them, for this, using the green color substance present in them, only they are preparing the food by sunlight. Okay, what we call these processes? Photosynthesis. They also use what? Water and carbon dioxide, right? Sun. First they need sun, then carbon dioxide, then water. Leaf prepare their food in the presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide, water. What we call these processes? Photosynthesis. Okay, ma? Then gas exchange, respiration. Okay, what is meant by respiration? Oxygen is given out in this process. The food prepared by leaves ultimately gets stored in a different parts of the plants. Okay, the oxygen is given out in this process. Okay, in this process, in this photosynthesis, oxygen is going out in this process. The food prepared by leaves ultimately gets stored in different parts of plants. Okay, then water transport, transpiration. What is meant by transpiration? The stem supplies leaf with water. Okay, what is the purpose of stamp? It supplies leaf with water. Okay, the leaf uses the water to make what? Food. Okay, the leaf also lose water through what? Transpiration. Okay ma, these are about transpiration. These are the functions of transpiration. Okay, first we study about the parts of leaf, then what? Classification of leaf, then classification of plant, then about root, then about stem, then leaf. Next class we study about root, flower, etc. Okay, thank you.